Silvercrest was for me a magical place, a place without the usual rules. We were given wide latitude about how we spent our days fishing, swimming, and a lot of goofing around. The ground was soft with a bed of pine needles, the cabins were rustic, and the little town of Wautoma was quaint and friendly.
So tell me about Silvercrest.
Well, Silvercrest was our happy place. We went there year after year after year, and nobody ever complained. We all looked forward to it all year. The year I was born, however, we didn't go because I was 2 weeks late and Jim said I looked like a little prune when I got home. And so we didn't go, and so my reputation as a disruptor of the family was immediately intact. But let me tell you about getting to Silvercrest, because that's the story. First of all, when I was born during the war, so we had one car. And we would all, I don't know how we all got in the one car, but we did. And one year we were headed up there and the tire blew. And this was during the war when rubber was really important. So they went to a gas station and the gas station attendant said, I've got one that'll fit your car, but I can't guarantee it'll run 10 miles. And they said, we'll take it. And they put it on the car and they got to Silvercrest and home on that tire. Another year, we took Joan Giacchino. And Joan, as a teenager, was not the most pleasant person in the world. She turned out to be a lovely woman, but as a teenager, she was a little strange. And she got to go because Mary Janice and I were always the outcasts, but Joan always got to go take the trips and so forth. So Joan came with us, and we did not appreciate her presence very much. And on the way home, I was sitting in the back seat of the car with her, and the car had plastic seats, and I peed, and because she weighed more than I did, all the pee ran down, and she sat in a puddle of pee on the way home. And when we got home, my brothers put me on their shoulders and carried me around like I was king. They were so happy. And so getting there was tricky. In the early days, my mom would actually pack a trunk of clothes and ship it by rail a week or two before we got there, because there was just simply no room for all the stuff. Later on, we took two cars and we were able to take our little 7.5 horsepower Mercury motor with us. So getting there was always a little tricky, but once we got there, it was heaven.
So what was a day like up there?
Well, there were no video games. There was a pinball machine in the bar. But mainly there was a little hook on a string and you tried to swing the hook and make it land on a little hook at the other end. That was a big deal. That was hours of fun. They had bean bags where you could try and throw them in the holes. But one chipmunk story. We all wanted a chipmunk. We thought they were so cute. We thought the chipmunks are so cute. We'd love to have one, you know. So one day one ran into a pipe where they were doing some construction. Oh boy, we got one. So we covered up the other end of the pipe. And we slowly shift the pipe and the chipmunk falls out and I grab him in a towel. Oh boy, ran over. We're gonna put him in the cage. We put him in the cage and he was dead. I squeezed him so hard. There was lots of swimming and fishing. We caught little bluegills and crappies and perch that we would fry them up, scale them and fry them up for dinner. There was a bar and a restaurant, so my mom didn't have to cook dinner. We'd had breakfast and lunch in the cottage, and then dinner at the resort. And my mom was known as the seven-stroke mermaid, because she would swim once a vacation, and she would swim out to the raft and then back, and that was it, and then she wanted a beer.
So what beer did your mom drink?
Well, first of all, my mom liked beer. She was like Kavanaugh. She liked beer. And when she traveled, she always carried a hat box, and she would tell the porter that there was a pink lace hat in there to be very careful, but it was really about three beers. And she drank Drury's, and Drury's was what my brother Dick called horse piss. It was not very good beer, but I think it was cheap, and we had a case of it in the basement all the time. So one year, when I was maybe seven, and Vincent was about five, and Mr. Ernst was the owner of Silvercrest, and he used to be a Disney animator. He was a really sweet guy, really swell guy. And he had stories and stories, you know, about the Indians that used to live up there. So he said, let's the three of us go look for some Indians. So, okay, so we bought little wooden hatchets, you know. And so Mr. Ernst picks us up and off we go out into the woods. Well, what we didn't know is that Dennis and Jim were waiting in the woods for us. And once we got far enough into the woods that, you know, that we were kind of isolated, we heard this, woo! Oh my God, you've never seen two little kids run so fast in your whole life. Back to them. And they thought that was quite funny. That was quite entertaining. And Bertha and Tony were the sort of the all-around people. Bertha would serve dinner and was kind of a maid, and Tony was kind of a fix-it guy and the bartender. And one summer, my parents could not figure out why I always had an ice cream cone in my hand. Well, one day they walked into the bar, I was about five, and I was singing McNamara's band on the bar for ice cream cones. And I wasn't a very good singer then, and I'm not a very good singer now, but I got an ice cream cone out of it, so that was really all I cared about. I don't have any bad memories of Silver Crest, I only have good